All right, we are back here at the Sioux Falls Arena. Our next matchup will be Brookings and Rapid City Central. We'll let you take a few minutes, enjoy the sights and sounds from the Sioux Falls Arena and the Class AA Boys Basketball Tournament.
Welcome back inside the Sioux Falls Arena. We get set for our second game of the afternoon here today on our semifinal Friday. It'll be Rapid City Central, who came into this tournament as the 7 seed, taking on now this evening, or this afternoon, I should say, the Brookings squad, who came in as a 3 seed but was upset last night by Sioux Falls Lincoln. Rapid City Central, by the way, lost to a number 2 peer last night, 60-47, in our second session of the day, setting up this consolation semifinal matchup here today. And Steve, this should be another good game between two teams who got potent offenses, a couple great guards in this game, and we should see some fireworks on the floor here this afternoon.
These two teams met back on January the 26th in Rapid City. Brookings won that one over the Cobblers 54-51. So history on the side of the Bobcats, and both offenses kind of held in check yesterday. A great game between Lincoln and Brookings. Brookings lost 53-48, and Rapid City Central, they lost to Pierre 60-47. So both teams putting up almost identically the same amount of points, although in defeat. But I think we'll probably see a few more points on the board when all is said and done. But this particular contest, Brookings comes in the higher seed, yet they will be wearing the road uniforms today. And they have some great players. Tyler Nagy, the son of Scott Nagy, the South Dakota State men's basketball coach, is their main weapon. He's their point guard, averaging 13.5 points a game. Their other main scorers are Braxton Carlson, his older brother plays at South Dakota State, and then Caleb Vig, he averages over 10 points a game. And there you have the starting lineups for the Brookings Bobcats. Braxton Carlson at a forward along with Caleb Vig. Zach Page, the starting center, a great football player. And then Tyler Nagy and Zach Kress, the starting guards for this team. Page averages 5 points, 4.5 rebounds a game. Kress, 3.5 points, 2.5 rebounds per game. Their main rebounder is Braxton Carlson. He averages 8 rebounds a game. It was Vig and Nagy leading the way, the only two players in double figures. Nagy with 16 points yesterday. Caleb Vig had 13 yesterday in that loss to Sioux Falls Lincoln. They average 52 points a game, 42% from the floor, and 65% from the free throw line.
Tyler Nagy is going to be the guy we keep our eyes on today for Brookings. As you mentioned, the 16 points yesterday. Struggled just a little bit from the floor, though. 3 of 14 from the floor overall and had 9 turnovers. Look for him to maybe secure the basketball a little bit better, maybe take some more high percentage shots and to lead this Brookings team today. But again, his matchup will be against John Fierro in Rapid City Central. Fierro, 4 of 13 yesterday from the floor, similar numbers to what Nagy had. He had 12 points, 5 turnovers in that game. As you get a look at Rapid City Central's starting lineup, and they've got another senior-laden group there. 3 seniors, 2 juniors, Ian Barce, Nathan Miller, Mitchell Newhouse, the big 6'6 center, is going to be forcing his will inside in the post position today, along with Jake Seals, the 6'1 guard. And of course, as we mentioned, the 5'11 senior John Fierro will be leading the way for this Rapid City Central Cobblers lineup.
Fierro and Ian Barce averaged both 13 points a game. Barce held the 7 yesterday. Fierro had a dozen. It was Nathan Miller who was their top man at 14 points and 7 rebounds. And Jesse Riddle came off the bench. Riddle, a 6'1 junior, he had 11 points in yesterday's contest. But the Miller was kind of the big surprise against the Governors yesterday. The 6'4 junior forward with the big game. Carry the slack. Jake Seals was shut out. He was really asked, Jake, yesterday to play to concentrate more on defense, hounding pretty much Lane Severin, the standout player from Pierre, pretty much all over the court. We'll see if the Cobblers can get more points out of him. The Cobblers average 55 points a game. They give up 58 on defense, 47% from the floor, 72% from the free throw line.
Neither team really has a dominating post player. Mitchell Newhouse, 6'6", has the ability to be that type of player. But as of yet here in this tournament, we haven't really seen a dominating post presence from either team. So look for them maybe to get that inside game working a little bit more here this afternoon. See if they can't get Newhouse working. And of course, the big post player, even though it's a bit of a surprise, Braxton Carlson, he's got the size inside. He'll be around the arc, and look for both of these teams really to spread the floor today on the offensive end. Let's turn it over to our public address announcer now, Jason Luth, with the starting lineups.
And ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Sioux Falls Arena. The South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard, welcome you to this game of the State AA Boys High School Basketball Tournament, featuring the Bobcats from Brookings and the Cobblers from Rapid City Central. Before we meet our starting lineup, let's meet our cheerleaders. Beginning with the cheerleaders from the Brookings Bobcats. They are Casey Brown, Ashley DeSmit, Brenna Chris, Corbin Wynn, Maggie Stanwick, and Brianna Vig. And let's meet the cheerleaders from Rapid City Central. Sarah Adams, Cameron Barber, Haley Cortez, Dallas DeCorey, Michaela Frederick, Jason Fuentes, Maverick Grayhorse, Marissa Hall, Sydney Harrison, Tally Johnson, Cassidy Mueller, and Takea Snipe. Now let's meet our starting lineups, introduced alternately and beginning with the Bobcats from Brookings. At a guard, a 6'1" senior, number 10, Zach Kress. And for the Rapid City Central Cobblers, starting at a guard, a 6'1" junior, number 3, Jake Seals. Starting at a guard for the Brookings Bobcats, a 5'10" junior, number 14, Tyler Nagy. And starting at a guard for the Central Cobblers, a 5'11" senior, number 22, John Fierro. At a forward for the Bobcats, a 6'4" senior, number 12, Braxton Carlson. And at a forward for the Cobblers, a 6'4" senior, number 15, Ian Barse. Starting at forward for the Bobcats, a 6'1" senior, number 30, Caleb Vig. And starting at forward for the Cobblers, a 6'4" junior, number 31, Nathan Miller. Starting at center for the Brookings Bobcats, a 6'3" senior, number 44, Zach Page. And starting at center for the Central Cobblers, a 6'6" senior, number 45, Mitchell Newhouse. Ladies and gentlemen, the coaches for the Brookings Bobcats include Tim Leese, Isaac Hansen, and Taylor Johnson. And for the Cobblers, Steve Anderson, Chris Clark, Roman Gentry, Keith Hauser, and Jeff Wimp. Head coach for the Brookings Bobcats is Travis Ingebretson. Head coach for the Central Cobblers is Mike Purcell. The officials for this game are Jim Johnston, Andy Deinert, and Jim Ricketts Jr.
In the black uniforms, getting set to take on Rapid City Central in their home whites. Both teams with red and white trim on the jerseys, and it'll be Rapid City Central who gets the ball to start things off, moving from right to left on your TV screen. Ball right now in the right wing, and you can see, as we talked about in the pregame, both teams are going to spread out their offense around the perimeter, really milk down the shot clock for everything they've got here and try to get the one shot in each possession. But neither team really with a big post presence to look for a lot of mid-range jumpers, three-point shots here throughout the day. They try to get the ball inside to start the day here, but Barse unable to come up with a shot. Offensive rebound for Rapid City, second attempt. No good, rebounded by the Bobcats.
Brookings started off man-to-man. I think the shot clock got reset there, even though it never touched the rim, but Central took another quick shot, so it really didn't matter in the long run, and Kress almost lost it.
Nagy with the ball at the top of the key is going to be setting up shop. He's the general on the floor for this Brookings team. Again, led the team in scoring yesterday, even though he had a poor day from the floor. Just 3 makes in 14 attempts.
Cobblers go man-to-man out of the gates.
Carlson up to the top of the key again to Nagy. He crosses over, backs up, 3 on the way, off the front of the iron, no good. Had to rush that shot just a little bit as they got it down to the end of the shot clock.
And once again, Jake Seals is going to have the tough defensive assignment, having to guard Nagy.
Jumper from the right block, no good. Again, Rapid City leaving everything short here in the early goings. Brookings off and running again. Slowing it down now is Vig in the right wing. 20 on the shot clock. Vig back to the top of the key, down to the right side. Eleven on the shot clock. Vig with the long two from the left baseline. That's good. First points of the day for Brookings. Goes to Caleb Vig.
Yeah, he had a little bit of a mismatch. Had a shorter player on him and just took that jump shot. Took the good opportunity presented to him.
Here's Rapid City Central with the ball now. 0 for 2 on each of their first two possessions today. Already down to 15 on the shot clock. Cobblers trying for the long two again. Off the iron, no good. Offensive rebound, the putback, no good. And the ball loose on the floor now, picked up eventually by Carlson. Central 0 for 3 in 3 offensive possessions today as Nagy drives inside. They're going to say a foul on the floor. That'll be the first on either team here today.
That's going to be on Jake Seals, his first.
Fresh 35 put back on the shot clock as Vig gets set to inbound it from the right baseline. Carlson from the free throw line, his jumper's offline. Rebounded though by the Bobcats. Zach Page got the board there for Brookings. And now a steal as the ball carrier, or the handler, I should say, Kress tripped on the baseline. Ball into the front court. Cobblers with the bucket. Nathan Miller tying this one up at 2 apiece.
Great pass set up by Ian Bars. He made that play happen, and Miller finishes at right underneath the bucket. And John Fierro is going to get tagged for a foul there for the Cobblers. And we've got timeout on the court.
2-2 your tie here at the first quarter of action. Just under 5 minutes left to go in this first quarter. We'll be back with more between Brookings and Rapid City Central after this on SDPB2. Welcome back in Sioux Falls. 2-2 your score so far today. Rapid City Central with a bit of a slow offensive start to the day. Just 1 of 6 from the floor. Brookings 1 of 3. Neither team really getting the offense off to a great start, but the Bobcats have the ball with under 5 to go. Vig into the left wing. Driving baseline now, going up with a head full of steam and laying it in for the Bobcats. Nice drive there for Connor Bestie, the 6-foot senior. He's got his first points of the day, and the Bobcats lead 4-2.
And the Bobcats come with some pressure, and they almost get a steal at half court as Zach Page nearly had it there. So Brookings trying to mix things up a little bit, applying a little bit of pressure. Central was patient with it.
Bars will inbound it into the backcourt. Seals, junior into the right wing. 19 on the shot clock for the Cobblers. Driving, Bars inside the lane, draws the foul. He'll go to the line for two, but again, the foul called on Connor Bestie. Tried to go in and swat the shot away, and Bars, 6-foot senior, heads to the line for two.
Yeah, Bestie came off the bench, had 8 points yesterday, but he got into foul trouble, and that hurt his team down the stretch against Lincoln. Bars 65% on the season, makes the first one. Bars, very impressive, 6'4 and a senior, 13.6 boards per contest.
Second attempt, no good. 1 point lead for the Bobcats as they make their way back down the floor. Nagy looking over to the sidelines for a moment now. Getting the ball into Vig in the right wing. Nagy back to the top of the key to Page. Bestie inside again for the right-handed layup. His shot no good, tipped by Carlson, but recovered by Bars, and here come the Cobblers in transition. Quick pass inside, Newhouse with the turnaround, no good. Bars, I should say, with the putback there for the Cobblers. And Rapid City Central taking a 1-point edge here now, 5-4.
Nice
over Brookings.
Yeah, nice interior passing that time by the Cobblers, and they crash the board hard using their height advantage to go over the smaller players from Brookings.
Nagy with the nifty ball handling there, got inside, his shot no good. Put back no good for Brookings, and now a foul on the Bobcats.
I think that's going to be on Carlson.
It's going to be on Carlson, yep.
And then for Carlson, that's his first.
3:28 left to go in the first quarter. Brookings, some more full court pressure. Daniel into the ball game. Mikey Daniel, a 5'11 sophomore. 3:24 left to go. Barce inside the lane again gets some contact, and it's going to be Carlson again. Back-to-back fouls on Braxton. He'll have to head to the sideline with his second.
And he'll get a pair of free throws here. As getting to the scorer's table there is Seth Morett.
5-4 your score here in the early goings as Barce misses his first. Morett into the ball game, as you mentioned. Just a sophomore.
Really a three-guard lineup out there now for the Bobcats. We saw them go to the pressure. I wonder if they'll keep that up. I would think so with the three guards in there. And now Rapid City Central, they're going to apply some pressure.
Nagy, double-teamed in the backcourt, crosses over, trying to center it. Daniel there, right back to Nagy, though.
Nice patience by Brookings in breaking that pressure.
Bestie finds Daniel at the top of the key, picks up his dribble. Bad pass, but it's recovered by Bestie. Three on the way, good! Connor Bestie, the senior, knocking down the tray.
Yeah, that was a nice step back, little three there. Near travel by Barce there near half court. Oh, he dribbled it off his foot, it's loose.
Daniel, the ball now picked up by Nagy. He'll push it, but numbers in favor of the Cobblers. They had four white jerseys in front of him. Now with a burst of speed inside. And the soft touch off the glass for Tyler Nagy.
That was a nice job. He kind of held up there. Cobbler defense kind of, you know, just kind of laid back a little bit. Almost fell asleep there for a moment, and then he just drove into the lane. It was a nice controlled drive there by Nagy as the pass goes out of bounds.
Yeah, Nagy was 0 for 2 prior to that, getting his first points of the day. Now 1 for 3 from the floor. Ball was tipped out of bounds, last touched by Brookings. Cobblers will keep it with 22 on the shot clock. 2:15 left to go here in the first quarter. Well, they wanted the three there for a moment, but they'll bring it back around to the top of the key. Back inside now to Barce. Underneath the hoop, Barce with the contact and the foul. He'll get the bucket to go and goes to the line to try to make it a three-point play the old-fashioned way. Like to see the aggressiveness so far from Ian Barce, the big 6'4 senior. He's been working inside, bumping and grinding with these Bobcat post players and finding a way to get to the free throw line.
Zach Page gets the foul.
Barce, 3 of 5 from the free throw line already today with his 5 points. Just 1 of 3 from the floor, but he's been getting to the free throw line often here in this first quarter of action.
Yeah, Barce had only 7 points yesterday, and right now he is at 7 points. So he's matched already his total from yesterday. Of course, he had a time struggling against that interior peer defense, as pretty much everybody has this year.
Bestie into the front court, kicks it to the left baseline, going in for the right-hand layup, no good. Bestie's there to clean it up. 4 points for Bestie as he continues to have a good afternoon here in Sioux Falls. Taking a look at his numbers on the day already. Bestie is 7 points.
A three by John Fierro.
12-11, Rapid City Central with the edge. Bestie again kicking it into the front court. Page. Back to the top of the key to Nagy.
Seen both of our matchups here so far, teams doing a lot more full court pressures. That shot's missed.
Cobblers are going to try to push it here into the front court. Seals up to the top of the key. And he tried to tip pass it to Barce. They're going to say it was last touched by Daniel, though. Jim Ricketts Jr. all over that one. And it'll stay in the hands of the Cobblers. Fortunate break there for Rapid City Central. Kind of a lazy pass that time by Seals.
Caleb Vig will replace Tyler Nagy in the Bobcat lineup. A little bit bigger lineup out there now for Brookings. As Rapid City Central has been very effective inside in this early going, and now Bobcats switching up to a 2-3 zone.
Seals with the ball to the top of the key, into the left wing.
Brookings showed that yesterday, that they will switch up frequently between man and zone.
Three from the left wing, off the right side of the iron, no good. And it looks like it's gonna be an offensive foul called on Rapid City Stevens. Make that Rapid City Central, I beg your pardon. Mitchell Newhouse picking up the foul.
Team's third, his first, as coming into the game is Trevor Lorenz. His first appearance, 6'3 junior. He'll replace Newhouse here for the final moments of this first quarter.
Daniel will bring it up now for the Bobcats. Nagy heading to the bench for a moment. Ball to the top of the key for the Bobcats. Stepping up to the free throw line is Vig. Daniel with the three now. Correction, actually, that's Bestie knocking down the tray. Connor Bestie coming up big in this first quarter of action.
Got 10 points.
Mars. 24 on the game clock. Shot clock turned off. Fierro for three. Good.
Second of the day for John Fierro.
15-14 Central with the one-point edge. Now down to 10 seconds. Daniel is going to push it up into the right wing. Vig's going to probably get it for the last look. Back to Daniel in the right wing. Steps back. Three on the way. Off the front of the iron. Fierro with the rebound. And that's how your first quarter comes to an end. Exciting stuff in Sioux Falls. Right now, though, it's Rapid City Central leading Brookings 15-14. This is the AA Boys State Basketball Tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting right here on SD. Getting a good look at the student section as we come back to the Sioux Falls Arena. The Brookings faithful getting ready for their second quarter of action. Right now, it's Rapid City Central with the early lead, 15-14.
Connor Bestie leading the way with the Bobcats with 10. Barst, top scorer for the Cobblers. And there's another three for Connor Bestie. Boy, he's feeling it.
Bobcats up by two here as we get the second quarter underway. 17-15 your score. More full court pressure from the Bobcats. Rapid City Central setting up the offense now. And Seals wanted to hand it off to Fierro. Instead, keeps it himself in the right wing. Barst. Underneath, double teamed, has the ball taken out of his hands. Recovered by Brookings. It's going to be Kress who comes up with it. Didn't talk about Kress a whole lot last night as Nagy goes inside, finds Kress back underneath. What a pass by Tyler Nagy. Kress finishes the play, but the assist goes to Nagy, and the Bobcats now with a 4-point edge over Rapid City Central.
Nagy drew three defenders to him, and Kress was just wide open underneath the bucket.
Fierro for three, no, off the left side of the iron, rebounded by the Bobcats, and momentum starting to shift sides here to Brookings as Vig gets it into the left wing. Back to the top of the key, and a foul call is going to be a push on Fierro. For John Fierro, that's going to be his second.
And Nathan Miller, he'll replace Bars in the lineup. Another sub in for the Cobblers, Noah Finsky, sophomore. So a couple of subs in here. Jesse Riddle also in. He had 11 points, number 21 for the Cobblers. Or had 11 points yesterday, I should say.
Nagy gets it to the top of the key. Bestie with a quick three. Good! He's feeling it here in Sioux Falls. Raises his hands, imploring the crowd to get up on their feet. But Bestie on another planet here in this first half. He'll dive into the stands, jumped over the seats in the front row. Boy, it's the Connor Bestie show here today in Sioux Falls.
And his teammates are smiling like, man, this guy's going full throttle right now as Mitchell Newhouse gets up to the scorer's table to replace Trevor Lorenz in the Cobbler lineup.
22-15, Bobcats with the lead. 16 of the 22 points have come from Connor Bestie here in the first half. My goodness.
And he doesn't even start for the team. But he's one of those guys, he's like, you know, comes off the bench with some instant offense. Of course, you always think of Vinny the Microwave Johnson from the Pistons back in the days. That was his specialty, and Connor Bestie doing his best imitation.
Bobby Jackson, of course, the longtime Golden Gopher, was the sixth man of the year many times in the NBA.
Come off the bench and start lighting it up. He could get you 14, 15 points just like that.
Long three out the shot clock winding down. No good. Rebound offensively by the Cobblers. Bestie reaching in just one time too many that time. He got the right hand of Rapid City Central's Noah Fenske, and he'll go to the line here now for a pair of free throws with 6:05 left to go in this first half of action.
For Bestie, that's his second personal foul. Fenske, this is first appearance of the tournament.
Free throw's good.
He's a 5'11 sophomore.
Newhouse with some words of advice for Fenske as he toes the line again. Second attempt coming up now. Trying to cut away at this deficit. He makes them both. 22-17, back to a 5.2 possession lead here for the Bobcats.
Central dropping back. man-to-man, and they're going to put Fenske on Bestie.
Nagy gets a screen into the left wing, picks up his dribble back to Bestie, top of the key, another three on the way. Good! Connor Bestie with his fourth three of the game. He's got 19 first half points. This crowd really going at every step Bestie has here on the floor. They are just loving what they've seen from the young man off the bench from Brookings.
And that foul on Zach Kress, that will be the fifth on the Bobcats. Mikey Daniel checks in. Nagy's going to go to the bench. So Mikey Daniel, 5'11 sophomore, number 22 for the Bobcats into the game to give Nagy a break.
And we said a moment ago that was his fourth three. It's actually his fifth three. Now a steal in the backcourt. Goes in for the layup and the bucket. No contact on the play there. He gets it easily and has already got 21 points here in the first half.
Wow.
27-17, 10-point lead for the Bobcats. Newhouse at the free throw line gets caught up and a foul is going to be called on the Bobcats. That'll go against, let's see here, I think Seth Moret is going to get tagged for that one. 6'3 sophomore.
Couple of subs in. Fierro Lorenz in for the Cobblers and checking in for the Bobcats, Zach Page. Wow, Connor Bestie, 21 points at this juncture.
5:19 left to go. Newhouse at the free throw line. Again, pretty good day yesterday for Newhouse. We'll talk about his numbers in just a moment. Free throw off the front of the iron, rebounded by Zach Page. Newhouse missed it there, but as we mentioned, not a terrible day for this cobbler. Yesterday with the 14 points. Jumper from Daniel off the right side of the iron, no good. Fierro with the rebound. He'll push it into the front court and gets fouled. A little pushing and shoving going on between Zach Kress and Fierro on the near sideline on your screen.
And that will be another one-and-one opportunity. Bars coming in for the Cobblers. Nagy in for the Bobcats.
Yeah, again, 17, make that 18 fouls now on the Bobcats here in the first half. But they've been riding the hot play of Connor Bestie off their bench, the senior, wanting to make his mark before he exits the AA high school rankings. Fierro with the free throw, that's good.
He's got 7 points. John Fierro, 77% on the season from the free throw line.
Second one's good, and we've got immediate timeout on the floor. 4:59 left to go in this first half. Brookings leading 27-19. This is the South Dakota Boys AA State Tournament from Sioux Falls, right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Back in Sioux Falls in what has been a wild start to day two of this tournament here in Sioux Falls, the AA Boys State Basketball Tournament. Right now it's Brookings with the edge over Rapid City Central, 27-19. We'll get you some scores from around the rest of the tournaments in just a short while. The A tournament wrapping up their first game in just a short while. And then they'll get to their second game of the afternoon going. Second game already in the B tournament, midway through their first half of action as well. We'll get you some scores in just a little while. Nagy from the right wing with the mid-range jumper. That one's good. Long two for Nagy. 4.5 minutes left to go as he gets into the scoring column now. 4 points on the day for Nagy. Newhouse into the front court, has his shot swatted out of bounds, and Connor Bestie pumping his chest a little bit there as he swats it again. 21 points. He's already got a handful of steals on the day.
He's been doing everything so far for the Bobcats.
Bars gets the inbound, stops at the right baseline. His jumper's no good. Daniel with the rebound. Spearfish and Clark Willow Lake with about 4 minutes left to go in the A tournament. It's Clark Willow Lake 52-39 over Spearfish with 4 minutes left to go in that first game of the day. From the B tournament, James Valley Christian taking on Arlington, and it's James Valley with the 24-16 lead with just under 5 minutes to go there in the second quarter. Put back for Bars is good for Rapid City Central back here in Sioux Falls.
Bestie hit the deck pretty hard there on that play, but he looks to be okay as Bars cleans things up.
Bobcats had a double-digit lead a moment ago, but now back to an 8-point lead over Rapid City Central here, 29-21. Bestie bounces it inside to Vig, but he couldn't handle the pass. Picked up by Seals, and he'll push it into the front court. Vig behind him. Nagy tips it out of bounds as they try to get it into the corner quickly. Good idea that time by the Cobblers, but again, this Bobcat defense, when they're playing well, gets their hands inside the passing lanes like we've seen, and Bestie getting a rounding ovation here from the crowd as he takes a seat on the bench now for Brookings.
Nathan Miller going to check in. He'll replace Finsky in the Cobbler lineup. And the thing that with Brookings, they've got a lot of quick players. And when you got a guy like Nagy, especially on top of that 2-3 zone defense, such a smart player, you can anticipate those passes, close off those passing lanes.
29-21 your score. Just over 3 minutes left to go here in this first half. Seals wanted to hand it off, lost his footing. Good. Luckily, Newhouse was there to help him out. 14 on the shot clock now. Bars at the free throw line, gets fouled. Zach Page is gonna pick up another one.
If so, that is his second in the act of shooting. Bars back to the line where he is 3 of 5 on the day and has 9 points overall.
5 rebounds to go along with those 9 points. We said that there really isn't a true post presence here for either team. Newhouse has some size, Bars has some size, but really, they like to shoot the three. They like to get those jumpers, not gonna really get guys posting up. You could see even that time, Bars was standing at the free throw line as he was fouled there. But at least these two players in Newhouse and Bars are getting more involved inside today. Newhouse with the rebound after the miss, and now called for the travel as he came back down and lost his footing.
Great effort by Mitchell Newhouse, just couldn't keep his footing there. Mitchell, he averages 6 points, 5 boards a game, as the Cobblers, they're going for a trap. They almost got it.
Nagy on the far sideline, now inside the lane. Steps in, pass behind his back, but it's rejected. A foul coming in late underneath. Jake Seals got his hand on that one, the 6'1 junior. Swatted away the shot attempt there by Seth Moret, but it'll send Moret to the line.
That's the second on Jake Seals. That was a pretty good defensive play.
Moret still looking for his first points of the day. He's got a rebound and an assist. That was just his first attempt at the hoop there, and he got fouled in the process. Now at the free throw line for the first time. Missed his first. Second, off the back of the iron, rattles around. Ball loose, tipped. Tipped again, and it'll go out of bounds. They'll say last touched by the Bobcats. Zach Kress working hard inside to try to keep that one in the Bobcats' possession. But it'll go back to the Cobblers here now with 2:51 left to go in this first half.
Now Brookings. Ooh, Fierro pass. He had to come and get it.
Fierro pass inside. Ball's going to go through. That was a great possession there by the Cobblers. The ball didn't touch the ground until it got into the front court. Fierro dribbled it twice, found the player inside, and got the bucket to go. Just a great possession there for Rapid City Central as they try to get back into this one. Two possession lead right now for the Bobcats, 29-23. Just a 6-point edge for Tyler Nagy and his crew. Vig shoots it off the glass, no good. Newhouse fighting inside hard, comes up in the hands of Seals. He'll push it into the front court. Well, not yet, because he gets it to Bars now. Jump stop inside the lane, off the right side of the iron. Newhouse with the rebound, but it's taken away by Nagy. He'll push it, 2-on-2 fast break. Nagy almost lost the handle, goes inside. No foul, no bucket. Ball rebounded by the Cobblers. And here we go again, off and running. Miller nearly lost it, recovered by Seals. Now he's double teamed, bounces it up to the free throw line, but only Nagy was there. Now a foul called. It's gonna be on Bars as Nagy tried to split between the defender and the sideline.
Things a little out of control there for Rapid City Central, and you don't wanna make an errant pass when Tyler Nagy's on the floor, because he'll pick it off. Fenske's gonna come in. Replace Miller. Fierro checks out as well. And Jesse Riddle into the game for the Cobblers.
Bobcats lead by 6, 29-23 your score. Ball to the top of the key. Nagy, crossover dribble, now back to the top. And a travel is going to be called on the Bobcats. It's going to be Bestie who took the extra step.
Yeah, he came around a screen. Fenske was trying to fight through it, but he took the extra step. That was a turnover there.
Well, a chance for the Cobblers to claw back into this one again. Still just down by six as Bars goes inside, splits the two defenders, shot off the glass is good. And again, the Bobcats didn't want to commit another foul, though, so Seth Moret essentially let him go through there, hoping to get a piece of the ball as he passed by, but again, Bars with a nice move to get inside.
Yeah, he's got 11 points now, top man for the Cobblers.
Bestie again, floating it in this time. Unbelievable, he's now 9 of 11 from the floor in the first half with 23 points for this Bobcat squad. Seals finds the shooter in the corner, back to the top of the key. Bars wants a three, good!
That was a long range three for Ian Bars, the 6'4 senior for the Cobblers.
First 3-point attempt of the day. He's now 5 of 8 from the floor. He's got 14 points. 31-28 your score. A couple big time players coming up in a big time situation here at the AA state tournament. Tyler Nagy with the nifty bounce pass, but it ends up in the hands of Bars. Bars into the front court. 18 on the game clock. Shot clock turned off now here at the arena. Bobcats with a chance to tie it here if they can get a three. They're looking inside to Newhouse though. Seals has the pass taken by Bestie. He'll go all the way in for the right-handed lay-in.
What a way for him to finish the first half.
And another near steal for Bestie. They'll throw up the prayer, no. That's how your first half comes to an end. Bobcats take the lead into the halftime break by 5. 33-28 your score. We'll be back with more from the Sioux Falls Arena in just a moment. This is the AA Boys State Basketball Tournament right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota, SDN Communications, and First Bank and Trust.
Welcome back to the Sioux Falls Arena. It's halftime, 33-28. Bobcats lighting it up here in the first half. Connor Bestie leading the way. Partner, let's take a look at some of these halftime stats and update everybody on what's been going on here at the Sioux Falls Arena in our second game of the afternoon.
Well, let's start with the team stats first. For Brookings, they are 14 of 27 from the floor, 5 of 9 from beyond the arc. 52% shooting in the game, 56% from beyond the three-point arc. And they have... are 0 of 2 at the free throw line are the Bobcats. Meanwhile, for the Cobblers, not a bad half. 9 of 21 from the floor, 43%, 3 of 7 from beyond the arc for 43%, and they are 7 of 12 at the free throw line for 58%. Team rebounding, 16-13 edge in favor of Rapid City Central. Turnovers, 6 for the Cobblers, 4 for Brookings. Individually, well, what else can you say about Connor Bestie? 25 points on 10 of 12 shooting, 5 of 6 from beyond the three-point arc in just the first half of play. 4 points for Tyler Nagy and 2 points apiece for Zach Kress and for Caleb Vig. Meanwhile, for the Cobblers, Ian Bars with 14 points and 5 rebounds leading the way for the Cobblers. 8 points for John Fierro. 4 for Nathan Miller, 2 for Noah Fenske. That's the scoring for the Rapid City Central Cobblers. Points in the paint, pretty even. 14 for the Bobcats, 12 for the Cobblers. Bench points. Here's a differential, 25-2 in favor of Brookings. Of course, Connor Bestie getting all 25 of those bench points. Offensive points off turnovers. 8-4 Brookings, fast break point, 6-2 in favor of Brookings. What a first half, about as good a half as you're ever going to see, especially from a bench player. 25 points, Connor Bestie.
Well, you talked about the points inside the paint. We talked at the beginning of the broadcast of how important the interior play was going to be for both of these teams. Neither really had a big presence inside yesterday in their first game. In fact, both teams combined for 26 points inside the paint.
They've done that already here today at halftime. A much better performance from some of their post players. But like you said, Connor Bestie really stealing the show here so far today with his 25 points. Ian Barst doing everything he can to keep Rapid City Central in contention. He's got 14 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists, and 2 steals already today. That's a great stat line. 5 of 8 from the floor, 3 of 7, though, from the free throw line. You'd like to see him make a couple more free throws there, keep it at 50% or higher on the day. But otherwise, two players really lighting up the scoreboard today here in Sioux Falls. You see some of the sights and sounds from the Sioux Falls Arena. Tell you what we're going to do. We're going to step aside again when we come back. We'll get you second half action. It's the AA Boys State Basketball Tournament from Sioux Falls right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Back in Sioux Falls, Brookings coming back out onto the floor, taking up some warm-up shots before we get back to the action. Again, let's take a look at some of these numbers here between these two teams rebounding today. Rapid City Central actually leading the way in the rebounding column. They've got 16 rebounds. They're plus 3 over the Brookings Bobcats, who've got 13 total rebounds on the day. 6 offensive boards for Rapid City Central, though, compared to the 4 for the Bobcats. And again, turnovers are something that we always keep our eyes on throughout these tournaments. 6 turnovers by the Cobblers in the first half compared to 4 for Brookings. It's been a great game here so far today. Some exciting moments on the offensive end, Steve. Some great defensive plays as well. Should be an exciting second half here. What are you looking for from both teams as they come back out to get this second half underway?
Well, first of all, for Rapid City Central, they put in Noah Fenske to try to guard Connor Bestie there, and you know, he wasn't the first guy on him, so we'll see if he continues to be the designated chaser. And also Tyler Nagy, 4 assists in that first half. He has been a big part of this game, not points wise but setting up his teammates. And for Rapid City Central, they tried, I think, to go inside early on, and I wonder if they're maybe going to try to go to Mitchell Newhouse a little bit more. Of course, Fierro and Barst, their leading scorers. But, you know, Mitchell Newhouse, he's about 4 inches taller than any of the Bobcats. So we'll see if the Cobblers try to go to their inside game. And maybe that can free up John Fierro, who does have 2 fouls for some three-pointers. And while we got a moment here, update from the A tournament. Their first game of the day is done out in Rapid City. Clark Willow Lake over Spearfish, 61-53.
And just starting the third quarter from the B tournament, James Valley Christian taking on Arlington. It's James Valley Christian 35, Arlington 26. Another exciting one going on there today. And we've got some good basketball coming up again this evening here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting in our semifinals game. Our first one of the night at 6 o'clock tonight. It'll be Sioux Falls Roosevelt taking on Brandon Valley. And then at 7:45, it'll be Pierre, the 2 seed, taking on the 6 seed Sioux Falls Lincoln, who upset this Brookings team last night in our first round of action. So 2 more games coming up, and it should be another fun day of basketball here at the Sioux Falls Arena. Well, it'll be the Cobblers who started. Barst from the top of the key knocks down a tray.
Oh, nice, smooth release. Good pass to set it up. Brookings, they went for a trap, and that freed up Barst at the top of the key. Now just a little bit of pressure by the Cobblers.
4 of 8 are the Cobblers on the day from long distance, just shooting at a 50% clip now. Brookings 5 of 9. So both teams actually pretty evenly matched up. Cobblers just a little bit softer on the offensive end, shooting 43%, while the Bobcats shooting at a 51% clip overall on the day. Bestie trying to keep it going as his floater miss off the right side of the iron, runs down his own rebound. Nagy wants to reset the offense at the top of the key. Best again. No, offline. Bestie couldn't get it to go, but Vig with the offensive board. Jumper for Carlson's. No, yeah, it's good. Whoa. Looked like it was going to fall away, but it took the shooter's touch there to knock it in. Braxton Carlson with the mid-range jumper.
That's his first bucket of the game. I thought that was going to fall away too, but here's an errant pass by John Fierro out of bounds to the Bobcats.
Yeah, I think Fierro was anticipating that his teammate Nathan Miller would be in the left corner and said Miller was on the right side of the floor. Just a mental mistake that time for the Cobblers. Those are the type of things that you've got to avoid. That's the 7th turnover of the day already for Rapid City Central. Carlson at the top of the key. Down low to Page. Back to Carlson, right wing for 3. In and out. Couldn't get the shooter's touch that time. Carlson talking to himself like so many good shooters do on the way back down, trying to figure out what he needs to do to fix it. And
maybe a bit of frustration added to it as he picks up his third foul and will quickly head back to the bench.
Yep, and that'll bring Seth Moret into the game, 6'3" sophomore. As Carlson, that last bucket he had was his first points of the day, but he's got three personal fouls.
Carlson had just 3 points in the game against Sioux Falls Lincoln yesterday too, so a frustrating tournament so far for Braxton as he heads to the bench to think things over after his third foul. Fierro inside to Newhouse, got some contact from behind, no foul though, and he gets the bucket to go. So true to your prediction there at the start of the second half, Newhouse getting involved in the offense and it's paying dividends so far for these Cobblers.
And a nice drive and set up by John Fierro. Lane was wide open there for the big man, Mitchell Newhouse.
All of a sudden, the Cobblers back within two, 35-33. But answering is Zach Page with the jumper there in the corner. He'll get 2 points and extend the lead back to four now for Brookings. Two possession lead, in fact, for the Bobcats. Bars rolled his ankle, and we saw that yesterday. Nerman Krzalich rolled his ankle in a similar spot, came down and had that foot just kind of fold up underneath him. Bars trying to stand back up, and Zach Page at least showing some sportsmanship there to try to help him. But Bars had to go back down, and he is rolling in pain. They're going to allow the coaching staff and the trainers to go out and look at him. But even so, Bars trying to put some weight on it by himself.
That is a painful injury, and good sportsmanship there by Zach Page. Of course, he's an all-state football player, I believe, and they have similar injuries in football as well. So,
Bars is wearing some splints on both ankles, and he actually went down and grabbed onto his left knee a couple times, standing there, not really putting a lot of weight on it. And as I look at his left leg, it is shaking just a little bit, but even so, trying to work it out as Vig goes over and checks on him. These guys are all fierce competitors, but they've got the same goal in mind. They're the same type of individuals, essentially. Young men trying to strive for basketball greatness in the state of South Dakota. So a good moment there by the Brookings faithful and some of their players to make sure that Bars is okay. And as he gets some strength underneath him again, walks by himself back to the bench. You got to like to see that.
Jesse Riddle comes in to replace him, number 21. And a lot of these young men, of course, they compete against each other in a lot of sports, even though they're on different sides of the state, but they'll compete against each other. Maybe or maybe not they play in football, but certainly in baseball, they'll compete against each other in track and field, and they'll attend camps over the summer. These young men get to have friends in other communities.
Jumper no good for the Bobcats from the left block, rebounded by Newhouse. Here come the Cobblers in transition, again down by four. Fierro with the three from the left corner.
Smooth John Fierro with that shot.
Fierro's got double figures now on the day with 11 points. 37-36 your score. Nagy finds Bestie again to the free throw line, right side of the paint. Jumper's no good, but he gets a foul and will go to the line for two.
This may be on John Fierro. No, it will not be. It will be on Jake Seals, but that is his third personal foul.
Now, it's interesting to point out that the Bobcats are 0 for the day from the free throw line. They've taken just two attempts, but even so are yet to make one from the charity stripe. And continue to have an 0 for day.
You figure if anybody would make him his bestie, because he's just been unreal today.
He's yet to score here in the second half. Throws up the free throw and no good. Rebound by Nagy though, and they'll get the fresh 35. Nagy lobs it inside, trying to get it back to Bestie. Fierro got a hand on it. He'll get it on the near sideline now. Splints past two defenders into the front court. Jump stop back around the outside. Seals for three, no. And a rebound by the Bobcats. Going to the ground hard though was Zach Page. And the coaching staff for Rapid City Central wanted to travel. They didn't get it. And it'll be Bobcat ball, but a timeout on the floor. 4:46 left to go here in this third quarter of action. 37-36, Brookings with the lead. We'll be back with more in a moment from South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Back in Sioux Falls, 4:46 left to go in this third quarter of action. J.J. Hartigan, Steve Toom, and the entire crew here from South Dakota Public Broadcasting, along with some of the cameramen working the sidelines today from Sioux Falls Washington High School. Special thanks to them as Fierro gets the steal in the backcourt, goes all the way in for the right-handed layup. Stole that one away from Daniel. And just like that, the Cobblers have taken their first lead of the half, 38-37, with 4:22 left to go in this third quarter.
And Ian Barr still on the bench for the Cobblers, but they've managed to rally here in the last few moments with him on the bench.
Nagy with a nifty move inside, gets contact and will go to the line. But again, as we mentioned, it's that 0-for-4 day from the free throw line. Make it 1-for-4, I should say, from the free throw line for Brookings.
Jesse Riddle picks up his first foul for the Cobblers. Nagy got the first of two attempts. We're tied. Still tied. Seals, hands off to Riddle. See if they try to post up Newhouse. There he is.
Yeah, right side of the paint. Page behind him, and a foul's going to be called on Zach Page.
Ooh, and Newhouse hit the deck hard, but...
Uh-oh. He twisted his ankle too, but it looks like this one just a mild ankle sprain. He's able to walk it off. It's always the scariest right after it happens. You don't know how severe it is, but that pain just shoots through your leg. A lot of times when you get back up, put a little pressure on it, walk it off, it'll be okay. But so we've seen a couple times already in this tournament, guys have had to leave the game, put ice on it, and luckily there haven't been any breaks yet. We'll talk more about Nerman Kozolich and the Sioux Falls Lincoln team in just a while. He had to leave midway through that second half, of course, with a severe ankle sprain, did not come back, but even so, his team was able to rally and upset this Brookings team in regulation last night in our final game of four yesterday here at the Sioux Falls Arena.
Big in for the Bobcats, and Levi Pyle, number 13, in for the Cobblers.
Newhouse back at the free throw line. He'll have another one coming up here in just a moment. Newhouse, just 2 points on the day. 3 rebounds, though. Make it 3 points for the big man. Nagy finds Daniel in the left wing. 3:44 left to go. Nagy fakes the three, steps inside, now brings it back out around the outside.
Bestie on the bench for the Bobcats.
Big inside the lane, fadeaway's no good. Rebounded by the John Fierro, but he's fouled as he comes back down.
And Zach Kress will pick up his third personal foul. That is only the third team foul on the Bobcats, two so far on the Cobblers. And Braxton Carlson, he'll replace Nagy. And remember, Carlson's playing with 3 personal fouls.
3:26 left to go now in this third quarter. Rapid City with the basketball. Fierro in the backcourt, guarded by Daniel. Up to the near sideline. Back to the top of the key again, Fierro. They're trying to get it inside of Newhouse. He got a hand on it, but it was tipped away from behind. Moret got his hand on it that time. 3 minutes left to go now. 2-point edge for the Cobblers. Bobcats have a chance to tie or take the lead here. As Carlson looks inside. Moret back to Carlson, fadeaway no good from about 17. Kept alive by the Bobcats though, still 14 on the shot clock. Carlson rejected, now to Vig in the left corner. Back to the right wing, 3 on the way, no, off the backside of the iron. Vig had it for a moment, Fierro tipped it out of his hands though. And here comes Rapid City Central again. Fierro near the half-court line, guarded by Vig.
That was a great play down on the other end by Mikey Daniel. Go flying out of bounds just to keep it alive.
Carlson's going to pick up his fourth. Tried to block the shot, got too much contact underneath, and he'll head back to the sidelines again.
That's his fourth personal foul. This young man, Jesse Riddle, scored 11 yesterday, has yet to score.
Just a junior, 6'1", as he makes his first free throw attempt. Bestie back in along with Barce for Rapid City Central.
Good to see Ian Barce back in the lineup for the Cobblers.
He already has two big, bulky ankle braces on top of his socks, I should say. Wouldn't be surprised, though, if they took all that off, retaped him, and got him back out on the floor to see if he could give it a go. But like you said, running well as he made his way back into the ball game. Second free throw attempt is good. 42-38, your score. 2:13 left to go now here in this third quarter of action. Bestie up to Vig at the top of the key. He'll drive left side of the paint, goes in for the layup, gets the bucket and the foul. That's going to be called on John Fierro. 2:02 left to go now.
That's his third personal foul. Nagy's going to replace Daniel in the Bobcat lineup. Quickly, Nathan Miller in to replace John Fierro. Fierro talking to the referee. His teammates were going, John, come on over here and sit down, buddy.
Yeah, I think Fierro was asking Jim Ricketts Jr. more than anything what the foul was, and Ricketts was willing to explain it to him. Fierro didn't necessarily like what he heard, though. 2 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Bobcats playing some full court defense here. Down by one. Cobblers break it and get into the front court. Bars, top of the key, steps inside, kicks it back out. Driving inside now, throwing up the floater off the glass and laying it in. Jesse Riddle starting to come alive in this second quarter of action. He's got five on the day. Make that four, beg your pardon.
Yep, he's got the first bench points of the game for the Cobblers.
Big top of the key again, 20 on the shot clock. Bounces off Bars, goes inside, offense. No, they're going to call it a travel instead. It was either going to be a foul or the travel on Vig. He lowered that shoulder. They're going to say he traveled beforehand. So the ball goes back to the Cobblers now with a minute 24 left to go in the third quarter.
Yeah, Brookings really gone cold in this quarter, and Connor Bestie yet to score in this third quarter.
Three-point edge for the Cobblers. Ball stolen by Vig in the backcourt. He'll go in. Layup's no good, but a foul on the play. It'll be on Bars.
That'll be a second. And two free throws coming up for the Bobcats.
So Caleb Vig to the free throw line. Let's take a look at his numbers on the day. 5 points, two rebounds for Vig. One of one from the free throw line. Misses this one badly off the left side of the iron, though.
He's a 71% free throw shooter on the year, 10 points, 3.8 rebounds per game this season.
Vig, his second one goes off the right side of the iron and falls to the left. So 0 for 2. Cobblers into the front court again. Floater from 2 feet away is good. Laying it in for the Cobblers. That was Nathan Miller, the 6'4 junior. And it's the largest lead of the day for Rapid City Central, a 5-point edge, 46-41. Nagy, nifty little ball handling move, getting inside, floats it in from the left baseline. Used the left hand the entire way, but Tyler Nagy created that one all by himself. Under a minute left to go now, closer to 30 seconds actually. Vig with another steal at the half-court line, left-handed layup's good. Connor Vig starting to come up big, or Caleb Vig, I beg your pardon now, with 7 points on the day here for this Bobcat team. Bars needs to get it across the half-court line and a timeout called by the Cobblers. Mike Purcell realized his team was getting dangerously close to that 10-second violation. Elected to take a timeout to maybe set up the last shot of this third quarter.
I think he needs to reconfigure or have his team redeploy when facing this full court press, because last few minutes here, it's been very effective for the Bobcats. They've climbed back to within 1 point. And the Cobblers have been pretty effective bringing the ball up the court, but boy, the last couple times up, they have really, really struggled, and it's led to some Bobcat fast break opportunities.
Well, Rapid City Central, 6 of 7 from the floor here in the third quarter alone. They've been playing well on the offensive end and have taken the lead here after trailing at halftime. Even so, you can feel that momentum maybe starting to go back to Brookings' side here as we get closer and closer to that fourth quarter.
Timeout situation, 5 left for the Bobcats, 4 left for the Cobblers.
15 seconds left to go in this third quarter of action. Shot clock turned off. Seals dribbles away from one defender, nearly crossed the half court line. Now gets it back to the top of the key. Riddle stops right side of the paint, tipped by Bestie into the hands of Vig into the front court, but they'll run out of time. Nagy throws it up, but the shot will be waved off, and that's how your third quarter comes to an end. Rapid City Central holding on to the 1-point lead as we go to the fourth quarter. 46-45, your score from the Sioux Falls Arena. We'll be back with more in a moment. This is AA Boys Basketball on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Back in Sioux Falls, 8 minutes left to go in regulation. Who will win this one? Well, it's anybody's game right now. Just a 1 point difference between Rapid City Central and Brookings. 46-45 your score. Taking a look at the overall stats here so far today. Brookings 19 of 40 from the floor, shooting 47%. Rapid City Central a 53% clip on the day though, 15 of 28. They've knocked down 5 of 10 threes. Brookings 5 of 12 from long distance, but the Bobcats just 2 of 9 from the free throw line today, while Rapid City 11 of 16. Bestie for three, and he starts it off in the fourth quarter with a bang.
Yeah, he didn't score at all in that third quarter. Now he's got 28 points. The Cobblers outscored the Bobcats 18-12 in that third period.
48-46 your score here in the fourth. Cobblers with the ball down by two. Fierro up to the free throw line, kicks it back outside. On the way, Riddle for three, no good. Vig can't get the rebound, but now runs it down. He'll slow it up as Nagy wants to take his time, set up the offense as he crosses the half-court line. Back into the right wing, Vig. Thought about the three himself, now drives with the left hand, floats it back inside. Shot off the glass is good for Zach Kress.
Nice backdoor cut by Kress. Found the open lane to the bucket.
Timeout called by Rapid City Central. Head coach Mike Purcell wants to talk things over. It'll be a 30-second timeout. Rapid City Central will have three timeouts remaining. Bobcats, by the way, have all five timeouts left in their back pocket.
Don't forget, you can pick up a DVD of the tournament of your favorite team for boys or girls basketball. 1-800-456-0766 is the number to call, or you can log on to sdpb.org. Do we got an update from the B tournament?
Let's take a look around the rest of the state here. We haven't gotten underway in that game. In fact, neither team has really gotten things going. Arlington, though, versus James Valley Christian, as we take a look here now that we get the computer refreshed. 59-43, James Valley Christian over Arlington in the fourth quarter. The eight tournament should be getting their second round of games going up in just a short while. It'll be Aberdeen, Roncalli, and Pine Ridge in that game whenever it gets started.
This Aberdeen, Roncalli came in the two seed, and they were upset yesterday as Fierro gets it in.
Fierro inside, quickly spins around the defender in midair, rebounded by Newhouse, fouled from behind. That's what we've been saying Rapid City Central needed to do all day long, get Mitchell Newhouse involved, find a way to get him to the bucket. It's been a poor day offensively for him, but he's finding a way to get contact, getting to the free throw line, and now has an opportunity to get his team back at least within two.
Seth Moret, second personal foul. Team's fifth against the Bobcats.
Newhouse with just the 4 points today on one of three shooting, but he's a perfect three for three from the free throw line.
Yep, 76% free throw shooter on the season.
Second attempt coming up in just a moment. Central, by the way, now. We'll wait until he makes this one. Now 13 of 18 from the free throw line. They've missed just five all day, but again, we have to point out that the Bobcats have missed seven free throws here today. They're just 2 of 9 from the free throw line. Bestie with the high dribble into the left wing. Nagy now with it, 20 on the shot clock. Quick three from the top of the key, no, off the left side of the iron. Newhouse with a defensive board, gets tripped up, and they're gonna call it travel.
Rapid City fans can't believe it. Frankly, I don't blame him.
And Zach Kress went to the ground there, and it looked like as Newhouse turned around, tripped over Kress, and they're going to get him for the travel. But if anything, that probably should have been a foul. Bestie for three. Good! Bestie now with 31 points in this game, the highest outpouring by any player in this tournament to date.
And a turnover is Riddle wasn't looking for the ball. Coming up court against the press, Rapid City Central, a little bit out of sorts. Timeout called by the Cobblers.
53-48 your score. We'll stick with the action here in Sioux Falls. Take a look at these numbers on the day. Bench scoring for Brookings, unreal. They have 28 points off their bench. Actually, all their points have come off their bench today from Connor Bestie.
Yep.
He's got all 31 bench points, and Rapid City Central just six bench points here today. Points in the paint, though, even at 20 apiece here at this point, but points off of turnovers have been huge for Brookings in the second half. 13 points off of turnovers today here against Rapid City Central.
And for Rapid City Central, you know, they had the strong third quarter, but then Connor Bestie lighting them up, and then Zach Kress, that bucket underneath the basket, and just two free throws in this quarter so far for Rapid City Central, and then the unforced error here just a few moments ago. And now Rapid City Central, they're gonna have to dig in defensively here for the next couple of minutes as Brookings has the momentum back on their side.
6:22 left to go. It'll be Nagy inbounding it in front of the scorer's table here. Gets it to Vig, but he'll get it right back. Nagy, burst of speed inside, gets the defender in the air, spins around, shot off the back of the iron, no good. Newhouse with another rebound. He'll push it into the front court. Fierro. Fierro's gonna try to slow things down here now. Cobblers don't have to rush anything, but it's a two-possession game at the moment. They need to try to get some points as Fierro imploring his team to get into the right spot offensively. It seemed like that time the Cobblers just a little bit slow to get that offense rolling. Fierro will inbound it himself now into the backcourt.
Yeah, he was just saying, guys, move.
Could tell it just seemed like they were all kind of standing around waiting to see what John would do as he gets the ball to the top of the key, and now a foul on Bestie. Fierro coming up a little lame, grabbing onto the left hamstring. And that's always a risky injury, especially with all the running that goes on in basketball. It seemed like he might have strained his right leg just a little bit trying to get around Bestie at the top of the key.
And for Bestie, his third personal foul.
Fierro with a noticeable limp as he tries to get into the right wing. Gets it, now with a little bit of a burst of speed. Might have been more showmanship than anything from Fierro as Seals gets it. Inside shot blocked out of bounds. It'll be last touched by the Cobblers. Seals just in the wrong place at the wrong time there as Seth Moret gets his hand on it.
It's a great feeling not only to block the shot and then knock it off the guy out of bounds so your team gets the ball back.
Brookings coming on strong. We mentioned at the end of the third quarter you could feel that momentum kind of seeping back into their favor. It's been all Brookings in this fourth quarter so far as Veg kicks it into the right left wing. Tyler Nagy for 3-0 on the left side of the iron.
And I think it's going to go to the Cobblers.
5:18 left to go now from the Sioux Falls Arena. Our afternoon session of the day wrapping up here with a dandy between Rapid City Central and Brookings. 53-48 your score. Three blowouts yesterday so far, two close ones here in the Sioux Falls Arena in our consolation side of the bracket. Cobblers working it around the perimeter. Fierro drives inside, splits two defenders. His shot offline just a bit, but he draws the foul. And John Fierro back to the free throw line. 2 for 3 from the line today with 13 points on 4 of 7 shooting.
Caleb Vig just picked up his first personal foul, 17th foul on the Bobcats.
53-48 your score. Fierro can make it a one possession game here if he can knock both of these down. Makes the first.
Fierro 77% on the season.
Second attempt coming up in just a moment for Fierro. Again, one of three seniors in this starting lineup for the Cobblers. Second attempt, too short. Barely hit the iron. Under 5 left to go now. Nagy. Finds Bestie, top of the key again for 3. Good. Boy, when it's falling, they're all falling. He gets that one off the front of the iron, hits the glass, and it goes through. Connor Bestie now with a tournament best 34 points here today. Newhouse shot off the glass, no good. Rebounded inside and a foul on the ground. The shooter there for Rapid City Central was Nathan Miller. He draws the contact. And of course, with the Bobcats already with 17 fouls, that'll send him to the line in a 1-1 situation.
Seth Moret, his third personal foul. It will be the 1-1 for Rapid City Central. Here comes Zach Page off the bench.
Moret checking back out. Heads to the sideline for just a moment. And again, it's Nathan Miller, the junior, 6'4", heading to the free throw line. Misses it off the right side of the iron. Bestie with the rebound. He's got 4 boards today. go along with his 34 points. Ian Barce noticeably missing from the floor here for the Cobblers with 4 minutes left to go. Nagy lobs it inside. Vig is rejected by Newhouse. A vicious throwdown, though, and it'll send Caleb Vig to the free throw line. Newhouse making sure that ball didn't have a chance to go to the rim.
Second foul on Mitchell Newhouse. He's in the act of shooting. A lot of contact. He did have some authority on the block, but way too much contact.
Vig makes his first.
That gives him 8 points in the game.
It's been a hard-fought day for Caleb Vig. 3 of 5 shooting. Just 2 of 4 from the free throw line, though. Make it 3 of 5. And we've got a media timeout on the floor. 4:01 left to go. It's all Brookings here in the fourth quarter. 58-49 your score. We'll bring you more from the Sioux Falls Arena after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Well, again, you get a look there at the Brookings student section as we head back to action on the floor here. They're up 58-49 right now. Bobcats trying to get into the consolation championship game. We already know one team's there. It'll be Huron taking on one of these teams tomorrow. The loser will move on to take on Rapid City Stevens. As we wrap up our consolation side of the bracket here this afternoon, just under 4 minutes left to go now. Brookings on defense as Jake Seals and the rest of his Cobbler teammates try to get back into this ball game. They led by as many as 5 at one point. Driving inside hard as Fierro gets the roll and the foul. It'll be on Zach Page. Big time bucket there for Fierro as he tries to go to the line now and convert on the 3-point play the old fashioned way.
And for Zach Page, that's his 4th personal foul.
Fierro's got 16 today for the Cobblers, putting together quite the tournament run here between two games. Point number 17 for Fierro. He's now 4 of 6 from the free throw line on the day. As we look at his numbers yesterday, Fierro had 12 points, had the 17 today. He's got 29 in two games between these two opponents.
I think Johnson's gonna pick up a foul there, and if that one's on Fierro, and it is, that is his 4th foul. So if Barce on the bench may be injured, I see him on the bench.
Yeah, he's looking on like everybody else right now, though. Bestie for 3 on the inbound, no good. Got a hand in the face that time. Ball's gonna be tipped out of bounds, and they're gonna say it's Newhouse who touches it last. Coming in out of nowhere was Bestie. Tipped it, might have tipped it back into the hand of Newhouse. Much to the chagrin of Mike Purcell, the head coach of the Cobblers, and the bucket and the foul. Bestie's got everything working for him today. Unreal.
And I think John Fierro has just fouled out of the game for the Cobblers. A valiant effort today by John Fierro. Played just a great game, but 17 points is where he will end up.
He gets high fives all the way down his bench. Head coach Mike Purcell, a pat on the back. He did everything he could to keep his team in the game today. Might have even tweaked that right hamstring as he heads to the sideline. But John Fierro can only look on now and hope his team can find a way to win this. Free throw's good. 52-61, it's an 11-point. Make that a 9-point lead, I beg your pardon, for the Bobcats.
Timeout called by the Bobcats. They'll spend a 30-second timeout. 37 points for Connor Bestie. I checked the record book. They don't have a stat for, you know, most points by a bench player at a double-A tournament, but I know it's 47 is the individual game record. That was by, I believe, Eric Klein of Aberdeen Central.
Not out of the realm of possibility here in this game. He would need 10 more, but what a special day we've had. This is by far the highest point total out of any individual in this tournament this season.
8 3-pointers made by Bestie. The record is 9 by Ryan Knott of Brandon Valley back in 1990.
I was 2 years old when that happened. My goodness. It's a record that stood for quite a while.
I don't even want to know how old I was back then. I think 24, something like that.
3:21 left to go.
The good old days.
Yes, sir. The 90s.
I said this to some friends of mine the other day. So they go to school at USD. I said the 80s were a great time. Don't let anybody tell you different.
Flock of seagulls might disagree. Newhouse in the right block. Steps inside, shot off the iron, no good. Put back, good off the glass. Cobblers get one there from the bench. Actually, Miller gets the point there.
So now for Rapid City Central, you're down by 7. You've got to make something happen on defense with your two top scorers on the bench.
Page going in strong from the right baseline.
Nice play by Page. He was just hanging out along the baseline and just found his way to the bucket.
You're welcome for the Flock of Seagulls reference, by the way.
I never had Flock of Seagulls here, thankfully.
2:22 left to go in this ballgame. Jumper in and out, no good. Rebounded underneath, but tipped away by Nagy. Bestie comes away with it. And it'll be Vig who slows everything down again for the Bobcats. 63-54 your score. Brookings looking more and more like they may punch their ticket to the consolation championship as Bestie misses it. Gets his own rebound, though, from Newhouse. And now it's swatted away, but Newhouse called for the foul. Too much contact with the body that time. Newhouse didn't like it. He thought he rejected that shot cleanly.
And that's the third foul on Mitchell Newhouse. Connor Bestie to the line for 2. 19 fouls on the Bobcats, 18 fouls on the Cobblers. And a timeout called by Brookings. Or no, check that. Rapid City Central will call that timeout, down by 9.
Yep, they've got just one timeout left with under 2 minutes to go in this game. They've still got a chance to get back in this. It's just a 9-point game right now, 3 possessions essentially. But Rapid City Central is going to have to hope for a little help at the free throw line here. Bestie can miss a few. They might have a chance to squeak back into it, but the time is running out. And, of course, Bestie doing what he's done here today with 37 points. Probably has a good chance to make life a little bit more difficult for the Cobblers. But, again, he's 10 points away from the tournament record as far as an individual output in points in a single game.
Mm-hmm. And he's 1 3-pointer away from tying the record. Again, just checking through my program here, most points in consolation play in one game was 47 by Eric Klein of Aberdeen Central in 1990. That was a 3-overtime game. And also in 1991, most points in championship or in a semifinal game was Mitch Begeman of O'Gorman back in 04.
And I don't know if that counts on the consolation side of the semifinals, but
I think the consolation play one game, 47, Eric Klein.
Yep.
He was an amazing shooter. Out of this world shooter.
Well, Bestie's at the free throw line, just 1 of 3 from the stripe today. Gets his first.
Now, just thinking back to Eric Klein, you know, he had some of the best shooting mechanics I think I've ever seen in a high school basketball player. Ever.
Bestie misses his second, so 2 of 5 from the free throw line today is Connor Bestie. But again, with 38 points here against Rapid City Central. 10-point lead for the Bobcats.
Yeah, Rapid City Central, they've got to free up a 3-point shooter quick.
3 on the way from the left wings, no good. Carlson with the rebound. He got it tipped, but gets it back to Nagy here now with 1:30 left to play. Nagy into the front court, Newhouse riding right alongside him. And a little bump and shove there from Jake Seals.
That'll be his 4th personal foul. And it's still the 1-1. That's the 9th team foul on Rapid City Central.
Next one will send it to the double bonus, but as you mentioned, it's the 1-1 situation. Nagy, a supreme free throw shooter, I believe 71% on the season, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, right at 70%, and he is 2 of 3 on the day at this moment.
Second is good.
Make it 3 of 4.
66-54, and you can start to see some of the fans making their way towards the exits. They think Brookings has punched their ticket to the consolation championship game. Cobblers trying to keep themselves in it, though. Seals puts up the 3, rebounded by Carlson initially. It was tipped out of his hands. 3 on the way again. This time, Jesse Riddle knocks it down from the top of the key.
Trying to keep hope alive here.
Still a 3-possession game, though.
Nagy going to be fouled, and that's Fenske who takes a tumble near half court.
And that's the first foul on Noah Fenske. When you have a point guard like a Tyler Nagy who can just break a press all by himself, and in these situations where you know they're trying to get the steal, you know they're going to be taking chances, he's the guy you want handling the basketball.
He's the type of player who can close out a game in the waning moments, too. He's got the ability to draw those type of fouls, get to the free throw line, and really keep the pressure on the opponent. Misses his second for the second trip around, though. Riddle, inside, burst of speed, draws the foul, and goes to the line for two.
Carlson may have just fouled out here for Brookings, and he did. Tough day for him. He is going to finish the game with just 2 points.
Just 5 points in two games overall as he fouls out. Carlson asking what he did as he leaves the game. Well, that's his fifth foul, and it'll bring back in Zach Kress off the bench. Under a minute left to go now. Jesse Riddle at the free throw line. Bucket's good.
Riddle now with 8 points. He averages 7 a game coming off the bench.
And a timeout called on the floor. The Brookings Bobcats want to think things over here with about 51 seconds left to go. They've still got 3 timeouts left. Rapid City Central, though, with just the 1.
Hey, you got an update there from the Class B tournament. They were doing their second game.
That one just wrapped up. It'll be James Valley Christian who moves on with the 86-62 win over Arlington.
So James Valley Christian plays Langford tomorrow. Arlington plays Potter County for 7th place tomorrow. That's at the B tournament on SDPB1. And hopefully we'll get an update on the Aberdeen Roncalli Pine Ridge game. Of course, they got the later start out there in the Mountain Time Zone out in Rapid City.
Yeah, no update from that one right now. Looks like some technical difficulties on the website from the A tournament, but we'll get you an update as soon as we can. Nagy into the front court, gets fouled again, and the Cobblers trying to slow this game down as much as they can by fouling, but Seals picks up the foul, and I think he may have fouled out of the game as well.
Yep, that's his 5th. And Seals will end the day scoreless. And Jake Seals has played really hard. He's drawn the toughest of defensive assignments here, and he finishes his 2nd game in a row with no points as Tucker Berg, a 6-foot sophomore, number 10, checks in for Rapid City Central.
This will be his first tournament appearance. Free throws good from Nagy. Trying to extend it back to a 10-point lead here. 68-59 right now with 48 seconds left to go. Second attempt is good. 69-59, Bobcats looking like they're gonna win this one here today. Still a minute left to play though. Riddle at the top of the key, throws up the 3, no, well off the mark, and it'll go out of bounds. Back into the hands of the Bobcats. So that pretty much wraps up our semifinals in the consolation side. It looks like it'll be the Bobcats taking on Huron in the consolation championship coming up tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll have an all Rapid City 7th place game as Stevens lost earlier today. And you know, I'm just thinking last year we were at the AA girls tournament and turned out the 7th and 8th place game was Stevens versus Central, but that one was a memorable game with the great performance there last year in that girls tournament of Margaret McLeod, who did her own kind of Willis Reed impersonation, thought she was done. She was nursing a sore foot and came back out and led her team to victory in the 2nd half. 40 points for Connor Bestie. What a performance. Timeout called by Brookings. They're going to get a subs, and we'll have to do some research, but 40 points coming off the bench. This may be the single best reserve performance in the history of the AA boys basketball tournament.
Got to tip your cap to Connor Bestie. He came out, started the day 5 for 5 from 3. When you get that kind of start, you know it's your day, and this one especially belongs to Connor Bestie and the Bobcats this afternoon. They had to fight. They were down early in the third quarter by as many as 5 points, but this fourth quarter has been all them outscoring their opponent here in this fourth quarter of action in a big way. In fact, they're outscoring them, doubling up Rapid City Central in the fourth quarter, 26-13.
Austin May into the game, number 50. Number 24 in, Trevor Hornig. Number 42, that's Seth Frazier. Number 20, that's Carter Gordon into the game for the Bobcats. And Bryce McMackin, number 54.
Shot inside is good. The lay-in with the left hand, Nathan Miller. He continues to play a good game inside for the Cobblers.
Yeah, he's got 10 points, second game in a row for double figures, and there's going to be a foul.
Tucker Berg got too much contact that time, put his hand on the right arm. He'll draw the first foul of his tournament appearance.
And two free throws coming up for one of the reserves here, and that will be Carter Gordon. And hey, he can say he scored in the state tournament. And now
Austin May, the 6'7 junior, goes to the bench here for a moment.
RJ Helsper in. Got them both. Helsper had some older sisters who were very good basketball players for the Bobcats back in the 2000s.
Riddle steps back for three. No, off the front side of the iron. Ball lipped loose on the floor. Tipped back into the hands of the Cobblers. Three on the way from the right wing, off the front of the iron, no good. Bobcats get it and they'll run out the clock. That'll be your final, 73-61. Brookings moves on to the consolation championship against Huron tomorrow, starting at 1:45. Rapid City Central will play at noon as they take on their in-city rival, Rapid City Stevens, tomorrow at noon. We'll be back to wrap this one up in just a minute. We'll be back after the break right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank. Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota, SDN Communications, and First Bank and Trust.
Well, back in Sioux Falls as we wrap up our afternoon session here on day two. You see the final score there, Brookings with the win over Rapid City Central, 73-61. Let's take a look at some of these numbers between the two teams here today.
You bet. For the Bobcats, 25 of 51 from the floor, 49%, 8 of 18 from beyond the arc for 44%, and 15 of 24 at the free throw line. That's good for 63%. Meanwhile, for Rapid City Central, they were 19 of 43 from the floor for 44%, 6 of 17 from beyond the arc for 35%, and a very good 17 of 24 at the charity stripe for 71%. Individually, Connor Bestie, what a game. 40 points, 7 rebounds, 14 of 20 from the floor, 8 of 11 from beyond the three-point arc, one shy of the record as far as made three-pointers. 12 points for Tyler Nagy, 9 points for Caleb Vig, 4 apiece for Zach Kress and for Zach Page as well, 2 points. One of the reserve players that came in, that was Carter Gordon, and also 2 for Braxton Carlson on the day. Meanwhile, for Rapid City Central, a couple of players at 17 points, Ian Barce and John Fierro. Of course, Barce left with injury. We hope he's better and can play tomorrow. John Fierro fouled out of that game. 10 points for Nathan Miller. Barce also contributed with 7 rebounds as well, 6 points for Mitchell Newhouse, 9 for Jesse Riddle coming off the bench, and 2 for Noah Fenske. Points in the paint, 26 for the Cobblers, 24 for Brookings. Bench points, 42 for Brookings and 11 for Rapid City Central. Rebounding, plus 1 for
for Brookings. They out-rebounded the Cobblers 31-30. In the turnover department, 14 turnovers for Rapid City Central, just 8 for the Bobcats.
So that sets up our session for the afternoon tomorrow. In the seventh place game, it'll be a noon start for that one, and both Rapid City teams will be battling in that one, the 2-7-8 seeds in that. And then the 3-4 seeds in our fifth place game coming up in session 5 at 1:45. It'll be the number 4 seed Huron taking on the number 3 seed Brookings. That should be another good game as well. But two games coming up tonight. It'll be Sioux Falls Roosevelt, the number 1 seed, taking on number 5 Brandon Valley, coming up at 6 o'clock. And then at 7:45, we'll finish things off with number 2 Pier taking on number 6 Sioux Falls Lincoln. Two exciting matchups there, Steve, and should be two great games coming up in our night session.
I tell you what, that athletic matchup in the first game between Roosevelt and Brandon Valley could be one for the ages, because both of those teams loaded with great athletes. It'll be interesting to see how that one plays out. I think Roosevelt probably has a little bit deeper bench, but Brandon Valley, they've got some just superstar players led by Chase Marceau.
And then coming up tonight, it's that surprise team in Sioux Falls Lincoln. We've been saying that all tournament long in both the girls and the boys' side here now. The girls' team, of course, surprised everybody with their first ever state championship. And now it'll be Sioux Falls Lincoln's men trying to get back to the state championship for the first time since 2009. All those coming up on here tonight at 6 o'clock. You see the times there on your screen. 5 o'clock Mountain Time with our start here tonight with Sioux Falls Roosevelt, the number 1 seed, just one loss on the season, taking on Brandon Valley, coming up here a little bit later on this evening. We're going to step aside for just a short while, but when we come back, we'll get you those final two games on day two of the AA Boys State Basketball Tournament. I'm J.J. Hartigan. He's Steve Toom. We're going to step aside for now, but we will see you a little bit later on.